Yo, what's going on, my people? We back with another one. This is going to be Bugsy Malone, men. I know I jumped straight to three, you know, just following what y'all requested, but now I'm kind of itching and I kind of want to know what the first and two one, what the first and second one are about. So we're going to dive into the first one and then we'll do the second one as well. So without further ado, y'all know what time it is. Let's get it.
Bugsy Malone. You know? Mr. Snowman on production. Watch this, I got a brand new 3-bedroom crib with spotlights in the ceiling, it's sick. Got a beanbag in the computer room, all I need now is Grand Theft Auto 6. Got an office and everything cocaine white. In the morning it can get too bright, but it doesn't affect me these days, cause I've been staying up way too deep in the night, thinking about before it all went bad, before the day I met my real dad, before I knew about money and bills, and how they both made my mum get sad. Sat counting about 25 bags, I'm running out of elastic bands, cause it turns out, when you make money on the road, there's nothing you can do with the cash, so I jump in the S-Line driving fast, hope I don't bump into my stepdad. Could he say mental abuse is worse than physical abuse, and I wanna get him back, but I don't wanna do another custodial sentence in a 4x4 pad, and I gotta take this time to apologize to my best friend, cause we almost crashed. Let me try and explain, it's intricate because I never been playing, it's intimate because I never contacted a counselor to get rid of this pain. I walk with it and now I'm going insane, losing control of my own brain, watching documentaries on serial killers and feeling that I can relate. Did you find that strange? Yeah, okay. Well, let me get this straight. If I do a life sentence or I don't make it, it's cause I could not handle the pain. I don't wanna hear nobody complain about that's good talent gone to waste, cause if I didn't go through what I went through, then you would've never downloaded my mixtapes. So let me confide in you, let me get it off my chest. Turns out no matter how many tracks I make, I still can't handle the stress. But I don't watch all the indirects. True say man might see me as a threat, I don't mind going out as a legend, as long as I'm known as Manchester's best. So picture the scene, I'm sitting on my corner sofa in peace, until I got a call. Have you seen yourself in the papers? You wanted by the police. And I was like, what? And it was hot. But do you wanna know what was a lot? The night before was the night that I went on Twitter, had a direct message from Slough, just my luck. Let me do a Vincent Van Gogh, cause you know I paint pictures with words, and I still not published one book. I was in Panacea trying to get to the bar, and my man didn't wanna let me pass, push me into a family of brothers. Before you knew it, I'd already been crap. But let me remind these fools, into the devil I turn. They step back, I step forward, play with fire and you're gonna get burned. But I must apologize in advance, cause I didn't want it to end so bad. See what happened from there was loose. I was in the Manchester Evening News, it said he got violently attacked outside in a taxi, he was whacked and could've died. But that's how you know what the papers tried, it was self-defense, that's a blatant lie. I'm stereotyped, and do you wanna know why? I'm a different guy. When I was about 8, my mom moved to an area that was heavily white. I was in school looking like Wesley Snipes, Ben Sherman's in a second-hand bike, feeling like a donut cause I'd already been stabbed by the time I was year 9. Mom didn't want me to see my side, told me that too many people died. Between like 91 and 99 there was a gang war and violent crime. My uncle's face got tore out by the pellets of a shotgun like Frankenstein. I was sat with him in an M3 that could do not to 60 in 4.5, one hand holding the steering wheel, moving quicker than a Batmobile, driving around cheating mill when I was about 9, back when the hood was real. A villain taking securical boxes and I don't care if it's hot. You don't mean Russell Crowe when they mention the gladiator in the gang war book. The first guy that I ever looked up to, he was like Batman without a suit. Now it's my turn to try and put Manny on the map, I just hope I can do it like you. Hope I can get 1 million views, hope that I never get caught with food. Hope that Charlie can breathe alright in the smoke, cause I set fire to the booth. And when I realised the grime was English hip hop, forget about all the tunes, forget the playlist, I wanna go down in history like Tutankhamun. Bugsy Malone, leave that playback. I dedicate this one to Dane, my little cousin. You didn't make it. Rest in peace, fam. See you soon, my brother. Yo, it's Bugsy Malone. Forget the mixtape for 5 minutes. We need to delay that, cause it's something way bigger and way better coming. 0161, Manny on a fucking mat, rude boy.
I like that. I like it. I respect it. I mean, it's just expressing his life, you feel me? And like all the stuff that he's been through, which is a fucking ton, to be real with you. Anytime somebody comes to me with something like real, I'ma always respect it. Always. And Bugsy seemed like a straight up dude to me. He seems mad solid about any and everything. So big up to him. as always. And I'll be back with Men 2 shortly. All right? Peace. Y'all know who it is, man. It's the Crocodile King, dog.